All right, this is part two of solving linear equations. So we're just going to shake it up a little bit, go over, different possibilities. Let's say you have this equation, 5 equals x minus 7. Notice the variables on the right-hand side of the equation. So we still need to isolate it. We just want to know what x equals, and I have x minus 7. All right, so if something was subtracted from x, to undo it, we would want to add 7. So we would just have x on that side. But whatever we add to the right-hand side, we have to add to the left-hand side of the equation to keep everything in balance. So 5 plus 7 is 12, and we have 12 equals x. But that sounds funny, 12 equals x. I like to write that as x equals 12. For instance, if somebody says, let's say you're 25 years old and someone says, how old are you? You wouldn't say 25 years is my age. You might just say my age is 25 or I'm 25. So it's better to write it this way. Now, you could even change the problem. Since these two things are equal, 5 and x minus 7, you could just switch the order and say that's the same thing as saying x minus 7 equals 5. If you like to rewrite the problem that way to begin with, that works just as well. And then you would do the same thing. Add 7 to both sides, and you have x equals 12. Okay, so either way. But then we still have to check the answer. So let's do the check. So now when you do the check, take the original problem. The original problem was 5 equals x minus 7. It was not x minus 7 equals 5. So you might have made a mistake in your very first step. You want to, for instance, if you were taking this out of the book, you want to copy exactly what was written out of the book. Don't look at your own work even. And underline, make the T. And on the left side, there's nothing to plug in for x. There's just a 5, so you write the 5. And on the other side, 12 minus 7, and simplify using order of operation. Same number on both sides means 12 is the answer. So you can write the answer. The answer is just 12. Or you could put it in braces, which is the more formal way of writing the solution. Okay, here's one with decimals. Go ahead and put it on pause. Try this on your own and see if you get the right answer. All right, so what are we going to do here? Well, this time it's nice. We've got the x on the left-hand side. And we have x plus 4.3, so we need to undo it by subtracting 4.3. All right, now most people can't do that in their head written in this way, but notice what I'm doing is I'm adding a positive and a negative number, so we see which one outweighs the other, and there's more negatives, so we know the answer is going to be negative, right? This side's going to be x equals. And then what do? If you're adding positive and a negative number, you need to subtract. So we need to do 4.8 minus 1.8, and remember you line up your decimals, and then we subtract. So that's going to be 2.5. But since the negative 4.3 was bigger than the positive 4.8, in other words, the absolute value, there's more negatives. The answer is negative 2.5. All right, let's check. See if that was really the right answer. You copy the original problem and underline it. All right, so we're going to put in negative 2.5 for x. And now, again, I'm adding a negative and a positive. So you go over to the right-hand side. First of all, is it going to be positive or negative? You have a negative 2 point something and a plus 0.4. There's more positive. So you know the answer is positive. But when you're adding different signs like this, you have to take their difference. Subtract. And so when you subtract that, you do get 1.8. And all right, so on the left side I get 1.8, and on the right side I get 1.8, so yep, I've got the right answer. Negative 2.5 is the answer, not 1.8. So you could write your answer as just negative 2.5 is the answer, or you might write that as negative 2.5 using the braces. Not formal, formal. All right, here's one with fractions. All right. This time, again, the variable's on the right-hand side, and you have the variable minus 2/5, so we need to undo that minus by adding 2/5 to both sides. To be different, instead of adding up and down, I'm going to add across this time just because I haven't done any problems in this video like that. So here was your original problem. To undo it, you need to add 2/5 to both sides. Right? So you just have x on this side, so you have to add 2/5 on this side as well. All right, so on the left-hand side, remember how to add fractions? You have to have a common denominator. Hey, cool, we already have that. And then we add the numerators. 2 plus 2 is 4. So I have x equals 4/5, but remember, we don't want to write it like that. You want to write it as x equals 4/5. All right, now we want to check and make sure that's the correct answer. So let's do a little check right here. We have 2/5 equals x minus 2/5. You underline it. Kind of running out of space here, so that's 2/5. And then we plug in 4/5 for x, the answer, right? 4/5 minus 2/5. All right, and since it's a common denominator, I get 2/5. Checks out. Cool. So the answer is 4/5. So you could either write that as, it's okay with me if you leave it as x equals 4/5, but some teachers want you to write it more formally or just the number. So I'm showing you. Okay, here's a problem that's a little bit different. We've got an x term and a constant on both sides of the equation. So this is a little bit newer. So we want to make sure we have all the x's on one side of the equation and all the numbers on the other side of the equation. So we've got a 5x over here and a 4x over here. One way of getting them all together is to get rid of it on one side of the equation. So to not have a 4x on the right-hand side, you could subtract 4x from both sides. So what does that give me now if I just subtract 4x from both sides? That gives me x minus 2 equals 7. Now this looks like something else we've already done. So now I want to have just, to find out what x equals, I'm going to have to add 2 to both sides. And then we have x plus 0 or x equals 9. All right, made that problem a little smaller so we could see the check right to the right of the problem. So we write the original problem, which is 5x minus 2 equals 4x plus 7, and then we're going to replace x with 9. So on the left side, I've got 5 times 9 minus 2, and remember to do order of operations, so we do multiplication first. 45 minus 2 is 43. And over here on the right-hand side, we put in 9 for x. And that's 36 plus 7, which is also 43. So since I got the same number on both sides, when I replaced x with 9, then 9 is the correct answer. So we could either just write 9 for my answer, or you could use solution sets. Here's another problem. Again, we've got x's on both sides of the equation, but we only have one constant. So since I've only got variables and that's it on the left-hand side, I'm going to put everything on the left-hand side. So that means this 7x plus 7x on this side, I'd like to wipe it out from that side. So if I subtract 7x from both sides, then what happens is I just get, again, just 1x. Remember, 1x is the same as writing x. If it was a negative 1, you couldn't just write x. So we have x equals, and on this side I've got negative 4 and I'm done. So that was a little bit easier than the previous problem. Let's check this. I'm going to make this a little smaller. Okay, so let's put in negative 4 for x. So we have 8 times negative 4, and negative 4 plus 7 times negative 4. Now be careful to do the order of operation very carefully on the right-hand side. In fact, I'm going to write it as a parenthesis. Maybe that'll help. So 8 times negative 4 is negative 32. There's no problem here. And on the right-hand side, remember your order of operations. You need to multiply before adding. So do not add the negative 4 plus 7. So you've got negative 4 plus 7 times negative 4 is negative 28. And now I'm adding two negatives. So it's going to be negative, and then 4 plus 28 is 32. And that's it. Don't assume you did it correctly and not really do the arithmetic. You really are using the check to help yourself find whether you got the right answer or not. That is what is so cool about algebra. When you're solving equations, you can find out whether you got it right or not. And if you got it wrong, just start over. Don't even try to find your mistake. That's harder than just wiping out the problem and starting from the beginning. So the answer to this problem would be just negative 4, right? Or you could write using the braces, the formal way of doing it. Okay, go on to part 3. We're going to be doing a few more problems like this and then going on to a new property of equality called the multiplication property of equality. I hope you learned something. Remember me.